Hi everyone, my name is Mike. I'm a careers and employability consultant here at Leeds Beckett, and today I just want to talk to you very quickly about networking and really just some top tips on how to help you prepare for careers fairs, in particular with our graduate job show coming up. So I'm going to focus on networking, talk about like what it is, what you might think about it, some useful quotes from expert networkers that might help you. We'll talk about how you can get the most out of the fair by sort of researching and thinking about who's there, who's going to be there and how that's going to be, how it's going to work for you. We'll talk a little bit about personal branding, why that's important to have a think about before you go to the fair. And then we'll just come up with a couple of sort of follow-up actions that will be really good for you to do following the job show. So just a couple of things, you know, when you please complete the following sentence. You know, what do you feel when someone mentions in networking? What do you think? What do you feel? What sort of feelings does it bring out in you? So prizes here for these types of answers. It's if you're sort of thinking, well, what do I say at networking? Or do you think, well, it's a great chance to sell myself? Maybe you think that you're not confident enough with networking, or that, you know, some of the people that you might be speaking to might be, you know, why would they be interested in you? Maybe you think that it's really important, but and you have to do it, but you're not quite sure how. Or maybe you think that, you know, this is a really good option to get myself noticed. And we talk about networking a lot when we talk about careers, and we talk about how you can, you know, create networks and speak to people and develop opportunities. So, you know, networking is really important, but we understand that it's tough. It's not easy to do. It takes a level of kind of confidence and experience to get to be good at it. But you can start anyway. You don't need to be an expert to do it. And, you know, I think one of the key points as well is that a lot of the people that you meet in terms of graduate employers are really receptive to networking. It's a huge part of their job to network with students. They're looking for talented students to go into their graduate roles, so they're always happy for students to approach them. So you should feel good about that. That should give you a little bit of extra confidence. You know, you've got a warm reception when you're networking at a graduate fair, particularly like the job show coming up later this month. So there's just a quote here from Reid Hoffman. He's the founder of LinkedIn, and this is really important. I think it makes a lot of sense. So opportunities do not float like clouds in the sky. They're attached to people. So if you're looking for an opportunity, what you're really looking for is a person. And that's so important, because that really sums up networking. Because if you're looking for an opportunity like a graduate job or some work experience or a project to work on with an employer or a placement, whatever it may be, you're not just trying to find that particular, you know, that job or that work experience opportunity. What you're looking to find really is a person who can sort of open the door to that opportunity for you, someone who's attached to it. So that's why it's really important to get out, speak to people, speak to graduate employers, and really sort of do your best to put yourself out there, show the best side of you, and speak to people that might have opportunities for you and that you can also bring value to as well. And we'll talk about that as we go through. A couple of other things, you know, about like what is networking. It's the exchange of information or services among individuals, groups, or institutions. You know, it's the cultivation of productive relationships for employment or business. So I talked about that exchange, so what value you can bring as well. So for a graduate recruiter, the fact that you're a talented graduate looking to work in their particular sector, in their job role, that brings value to their network. And they have a graduate role that you are interested in and want to work at. So that's that exchange of information or service. among individuals. And it's, like I say, that cultivation of productive relationships as well. So it's all about who you can speak to, whose network you can join, who you can bring into your network, where you have that value that you can exchange as well. And why is it important? So I've mentioned a couple of times, it's really important for creating new career and business opportunities. It helps you have your sort of finger on the pulse, so like increasing your commercial awareness, knowing what's happening in a particular sector, what's happening at a particular organization. It helps you to learn from technical and professional people. So the people that you are going to network with at the graduate job show are experts in graduate recruitment, so you can learn from them how to succeed in the graduate selection process, what type of things they might look out for. So it's learning from them in that sense. Looking a little bit wider than the job show, you might be in a particular industry, particularly like a creative industry, for example. Maybe you want to get into film or design or sort of marketing or something like that. And if you can connect with and network with people from those particular industries, you can learn from them if they're from their expertise. So it's really important to do that. And also it's just a way of building relationships. Perhaps you might end up being mentored. We've had numerous examples of our students networking with employees at various different events that then ended up becoming sort of mentor-mentee relationships. And also, like I mentioned on the previous slide, if you're looking for a person, if you're looking for an opportunity, sorry, you're looking at looking for a person, and you never know what type of sort of hidden opportunity they might be able to present to you, something that maybe isn't advertised, something that they're just looking to speak to the right person about. So it's really important to network. And there's just another sort of quote I've got here. So it's networking. It's an excellent way to create your own look. So what that means is if the economy shifts and suddenly your plan A evaporates, having a strong network will help you to identify new opportunities. So, and it'll also make it more likely for you to bring up chance events that may work in your favor. So providing additional resources for you when seeking to make sense of your experiences. So essentially what this is saying is, if you've got a strong network, if your sort of career plans need a little bit of support, if certain things aren't going well, if like it says your plan A doesn't work, or if you aren't sort of maybe succeeding in your initial attempts to get into a particular industry, just connecting with people in those industries and in those sectors helps you to just create those opportunities. And if plan A isn't working, you can fall back and rely on your network of people if you've created it properly and sort of and thought about it and made it strategic of who you want to be in your network. And that's when those opportunities will come through. So how do you do it then? I guess this is the important thing. And how do you go up to someone at a careers fair and start a conversation? I think one of the biggest bits of advice I would give you is, we see so many times at careers fairs, students and graduates go up to the employer and say something like, "Oh, what's this all about then?" Or, what are you advertising? Just sort of really direct questions that kind of have no, don't really appeal to the recipient. So I think it's really important to be like a really interested inquirer and talk to them, be curious and investigate, what you might want to do. You've got to create an opportunity by having those personal conversations with people. So when we say be an interested inquirer, just sort of say, "Oh, hi, your FDM. I know a little bit about you. I know that you're in tech. I've got an interest in tech as a career. Could you tell me a little bit more about your graduate scheme? I'd really like to know more about how it works and what the roles might be like." That's a much better, friendlier introduction to someone, and like I say, be interested in what they do as well. So maybe you could ask someone, if you go straight up to them. I think a question that people really like is, what's the best thing about working at Enterprise Rent-A-Car? And that's a really good way of getting the person that you're speaking to, the employer, to sort of go into a more of a conversational tone, because it you're asking them about themselves, but it's in relation to what you might be interested in, and they're interested in you. So you can start to have that conversation and let it flow naturally like that. The worst thing to do is just sort of say, what's this about then? To try and think about how you can be more personable when you sort of go up and speak to people. And this is where you can do some preparation beforehand. So look at who's coming to the job show. Think about which companies you might want to talk to on the day, and do a little bit of research beforehand. You know, all the companies will be on MyHub, so you can take a look at who's there at the job show. But there's people like the Home Office, the DWP, there's people like Foot Asylum, Enterprise Rent-A-Car, Mackenzie Stewart, loads of different areas. So just research them a little bit beforehand. You might even find out who their graduate recruiter is and is likely to be at the job show. You could find them on LinkedIn beforehand as well. So there's lots of things that you can do to get a little bit of an idea about the company and even the person beforehand, so that you can make a more personable introduction. And this is what you want to do as well. You want to give just a sort of little elevator pitch. So once you've made that sort of first question, then you want to like introduce yourself as well and explain what you're currently doing, and highlight some things that you've done that will impress the person. And you know, try and link yourself to them or their company. So you might want to say like, "Hi, I'm Mike. I'm a final year psychology and criminology student. So I'm currently looking to, I've got a real interest in sort of the tech sector, and I'd really like to, you know, learn a little bit more about what you're doing here at FDM. It sounds really interesting." Or you might say, "I'm a final year social sciences student. I've got a real interest in the public sector and third sector. I've recently done some research as one of my projects about a particular part of like the DWP related to employability and employability support for vulnerable people. I'd really like to learn more about what sort of roles there might be at the DWP that might fit into something that I've done. That's the kind of thing that you can do. And again, think about what you might want to introduce to each different employer. And because this is an opportunity as well to sort of sell yourself. It's this why they call it an elevator pitch. It's supposed to be really quickly, you're supposed to be able to say it in the time it takes to get in an elevator. And it's just an opportunity for you to show yourself in your best light. So don't be modest here. It's really important to show the best side of you. So don't be modest, and just, you know, make sure that you're speaking to employees and telling them really good, great things about you that you've done either through your studies or your part-time work or volunteering or whatever it may be. So just some things about LinkedIn, because it's really important to use LinkedIn in preparation for the job show and also afterwards as well. So it's really important to have your profile up to date if you can, get it completed as much as you can, get as much info on there about your skills, your experience, relevant photo as well. We have got some sessions coming up on creating your profile if you're brand new to LinkedIn. So do look out on MyHub. I know there's one later this month, and there'll be ones running throughout the semester. So make sure you connect properly as well. I'm going to talk about exactly how to do that on the next slide. But don't just sort of send, you want to send a note, and we'll talk about how to do that on the next one. And be active, like posts and share posts, comment on posts if you're feeling really confident, particularly in the industries that you want to work in. So if you're looking at things like marketing, for example, there are a number of different marketing professionals that you can follow online, and you can like and comment on different things that they do. You know, some really prominent ones are Pretty Little Marketer or Gary Vaynerchuk as well. So there's a couple of ones that are, you know, you can just sort of get yourself within the industry and start to learn about you know, what type of content is posted by people in that industry, and just like I said, just like, post, like, share, maybe even comment as well. It just sort of gets you kind of noticed on LinkedIn, and when you join people's networks, they can see that you're active. And I mentioned when you connect with someone, writing a note, like, it's really important, I would say. So when you go to connect with someone, it will say, would you like to add a note? And it's really important here to, it just really helps with the person that you're trying to connect with. It helps them to understand why you want to connect with them. So just something along here, say that you are wanting to speak to someone at the job show. So for example, Mackenzie Stewart, you could Google them, you could have a look at them on LinkedIn. They're a search and select executive search company. About 30 Leeds Beckett alumni hired there last year, so they hire a lot of Leeds Beckett students. And it'll be, if you Googled them, you probably find out fairly easily that a guy called Nick Weaver is their sort of head of early careers and is likely to be at the job show. So you could send him a little connection request beforehand and just say, hi, I'm a student at Leeds Beckett, I'm coming to the graduate job show, I'm really looking forward to speaking to the Mackenzie Stewart stand and learn a little bit more about graduate careers. Like, if I'm the employer at Mackenzie Stewart, that's just so powerful, it's just so interesting, it's so memorable. It's just a small thing, but it really makes me kind of think about, okay, so this person is really interested in what we're doing, really wants to know more about our business, and I'm looking forward to speaking to them at that job show. And it'll almost make you stand out as well. And also afterwards as well, everyone that you speak to on the day at the job show, just take a little note, get their name. That's a really important part of networking, making sure you get people's names so you can follow up with them. And so that afterwards, say you speak to Chloe at Charlton Morris, then you can, you know, find her afterwards on LinkedIn and just send her a little message saying, I really enjoyed speaking to you today at the job show at Leeds Beckett. You know, would really love to learn more about the different opportunities at Charlton Morris. Please can we connect so I can see when they become available. That type of thing, like, that really holds a lot of weight, rather than just saying connect please with no note, no context. So really think about the notes that you want to write when you are you know, connecting with people on LinkedIn. So just a little bit on personal brand. This is something to think about before you go. Think about, like, what's important about you, who you are, what you do. Think about, like, what your values are, what are the principles that, you know, how you live your life, what's really important to you. So you can think about, well, what organizations have, you know, make sure you can ask about, like, this kind of similar values, and what organizations' values are, to make sure that they're similar to yours. You know, similarly, what are your drivers, what motivates you? You know, is it money? Is it making a difference? Is it being creative? You know, all of those things are different motivators for people in their roles and what they get job satisfaction from. Think about what they are for you. Think about what your reputation is. You know, what are you known for? What do people think when they sort of hear your name? And that can be sort of academically, or it can be within your work. And think about, like, what your sort of personality and character is, and what your skills and strengths are. Make sure that you know what they are. So one thing that you can do to figure out your strengths is maybe ask someone really close to you, friends or family, what you think that they think your skills and strengths are, because sometimes it's difficult to work out what they are in ourselves, but our people that we trust can find them a little bit easier for us. And then just some couple of final points. So again, I've mentioned some of the employees that are going to be at the fair. I would research them beforehand. The full list of the employees that are going to be there will be on my hub on the event page, but just Google each one, have a look at what they do, what their early careers offer is like. Why might they be at the graduate job show? They're going to be looking for graduates, but what type of roles might be they promoting? What types of characteristics and strengths and skills might they be looking for? What sort of things do they do in terms of maybe some of their more like, you know, social responsibility type stuff? What are they involved in? What policies do they have? What values do they have? Those kinds of things that you can use that information as conversation starters when you start networking with them. And it'll give you an idea of that when you go there, rather than, you know, trotting out that tired line that we mentioned at the beginning, what's this all about? Something you can say, oh, you're the department, you know, the Department for Work and Pensions, you know, really interested in learning a little bit more. I've done some research beforehand, and this is what I found out. I'd like to talk about that a little bit more. Or you might talk about Foot Asylum. You know, I hear you know, understand you're based in Manchester. You know, I'm interested in exploring roles in Manchester. I know that you've got a number of different roles, from sales to marketing and things like that. So I'd just like to talk a little bit more about those and see how I might fit in and how I might contribute. That type of thing. It's just, again, it's so important to help. So research the different companies that are going to be there, and just, it'll really help you on the day. So just some takeaways. What can you do? I've spoken about them a little bit, but create or update your LinkedIn profile if it's not done already. Have a look at it. Maybe find 5 employees who are going to be at the job show, or maybe 5 employers, you know, some alumni from Leeds Beckett that work in an area of interest to you, and connect with them via a personalized connection request. Something like that I mentioned, looking forward to speaking to you or your colleagues at the job show. I'm really interested in exploring a career at your company. Or as well, then what I would do following the job show, it's like I've mentioned, make a note of who you've spoken to and follow up with that personalized connection request on LinkedIn. Say, I really enjoyed speaking to you today at the job show. Love to be connected so I can stay in touch with you and learn about any other opportunities to work at whichever company it is. I hope that's helpful. Hopefully, you know, it'll be good to see as many of you at the job show as possible, putting some of this stuff into practice, getting the most out of the fair by hopefully being more confident in networking. So thanks very much. And good luck at the job show. Thanks very much. Bye now.